Hello dear students, heartiest greetings to you and welcome to our online class today. Dear learners, in the last class I have discussed on voices and I have completed the rules of voices and I hope you watched those videos and you have completed the topic and I also expect you all understood the topic and you keeping your practice at home. Dear learners, today I will discuss another topic which is called foundation of grammar, which is called the base of grammar. Without this topic, a learner can develop his syntax or any type of grammatical item. Dear learner, today I will discuss tense, and this topic is mainly for the students of class 6, 7, and 8, and for those who are interested to revise this. Dear learners, now follow the whiteboard. You can see our today's topic is tense. You know what is tense, and before discussing this topic, first we should know the definition of tense. Tense means time. Briefly, tense means time. Tense means the time of happening the verb. The tense means the time of happening the action. Dear learners, tense is of two types. Tense is mainly of three types: present tense, past tense, and future tense. Present tense, past tense, and future tense. Then each tense has been divided into four types. They are present indefinite, present continuous, present perfect, and present perfect continuous. Likewise, past indefinite, past perfect continuous. Likewise, future indefinite, future perfect, future indefinite, future continuous, future perfect, and future perfect continuous. And what here, sometimes present indefinite is called present simple, past simple, or future simple. Dear learners, follow the chart. In the chart, I have tried to show you present tense at a glance. Present tense, four types: present simple or present indefinite. Present simple or present indefinite, then present continuous, present perfect, and present perfect continuous. Dear learners, follow the rule for present simple. Present simple, first subject, he/one, that means base form of verb. Base form of verb, and sometimes this verb will be s or es form. Next, object plus extension, the remaining part of the sentence. Dear learners, again, subject, base form of verb or he/one, and sometimes s or es form, then object plus extension. Example number one: they catch fish in the field. They catch fish in the field. Here, subject, then cast, he/one, base form of verb, then object, fish, and extension, in the river. Dear students, example number two: he plays cricket in the field. Here, subject, plays, and here, notice, with the verb, s is added, s, because here subject is third person singular number. When in a present simple tense, subject will be third person singular number, then we have to add s or es with the verb. So we have taken here place, then object cricket, and last of all in the field, the extension, the part extension in the field. Okay, then continuous, present continuous tense rule, subject plus am is are, they are auxiliaries of present continuous tense. Am is are, then verbing means var plus ing, ing with var. Okay, that's why it is continuous. Verbing plus object and last extension. Dear learners, for the example, we are learning English. Here we, subject, who completes the verb, who does or do the action, that's why it's subject, we subject, then auxiliary, am, is, are, and of am, is, are, we have taken here are, because we are plural, we plural, that's why you have taken are, and if the subject becomes singular, then we have taken is and am for I. Then verb, learning, here verbing, and verb is learn, and with learned we have added ing, verbing form, ing form, learning, then English, object, here object is English, and there is no extension or there is no remaining part in the sentence. That's why we have kept blank the extension part. Dear learners, now we have to follow the rules of present perfect tense. Present perfect rule, subject have oblique have or has, then past participle or verb or V3 plus object and extension. Dear learners, close the example. Number one, Meena has prepared her lesson. Here subject Meena subject, then auxiliary has, since Meena is singular, that's why we have taken has, then prepared, past participle verb prepared, here prepared, main verb prepared, base form of verb prepared, and we have done past participle prepared, then object her lesson, and no extension in the sentence. Next, present perfect continuous tense rule, subject plus have been or has been, then verbing, ing with verb or verb with ing, plus object plus for or sometimes since, plus time. And for or since, we have to use for. We should take for when that time will be indefinite. When time can be counted by hours. And since for definite time. When the time will be definite, then we have to take since, plus time. Follow the example. Number one, you have been learning computer for 3 months. You have been learning computer for 3 months. Here subject you subject, then auxiliary verb have been or has been. Here have been. Then learning verb with ing or ing with verb. Okay, learning, because it's continuous tense, present perfect continuous tense. Then object, computer object. Then for or since, because in this case time is 3 months. It's not definite, it's 3 months, and we can count this time with hours. That's why for 3 months, not since 3 months, here for 3 months. Dear learners, This was the chart of only present tense, for present tense, present simple, present continuous, present perfect, and present perfect continuous. And I hope you understood the, you have understood the chart, and you have taken down the chart, and you have to practice this chart at home. Dear learners, follow the chart carefully.
Go.
Dear learners, now I will discuss past tense and the four types of past tense. Dear learners, follow the chart. Past tense. This chart is for past tense. Four types of past tense. Past simple. Past simple or past indefinite. Past continuous. Past perfect. And past perfect continuous tense. Rule. First subject. Subject, subject, V2 means past form of verb, past form of verb, V2, then object and extension. Subject, V2, past form of verb, plus object, plus extension. Dear students, follow the example. Here subject is they caught. That means caught, past form of case. Past form of case. It's called V2 also. V2. They caught fish. Fish is object. Fish object. Then extension in the river. They caught fish in the river. And next, rule number 2. Example number 2. He played cricket in the field. He played cricket in the field. Here subject he, subject, then V2, played, from played, V2, object, cricket, and extension in the field. He played cricket in the field. Past continuous tense, subject, rule, subject, was, oblique, where, was, or where, then verbing, object, plus extension. Example, subject, we. Here we subject, then auxiliary, we were. Here we singular subject, we plural subject, plural, that's why we have taken here, were. Then learning, verbing, ing with learn. Here base form of verb is learn is base form, and we have added ing with learn. That's why it has been learning object, English. And there is no extension here. Past perfect tense. Now past perfect tense, rule, subject, had, plus V3 or past participle, object, extension. And sometimes you will have with this part, another part that is past simple. Past indefinite tense, if we have that part. Here subject Mina. Subject Mina, then auxiliary had, past participle verb prepared, then object her lesson. Dear learners, now past perfect continuous. Rule, subject had been, only one auxiliary, had been, then verbing, ing verb, object, plus for or since, plus time. This is time. Example, you have been learning computer for 3 months. Here subject you, then auxiliary had been, then ing with verb, here learn is verb, learn, and when we will do verbing, then the form of verb will be learning, computer object, then for 3 months. Dear learners, this was the chart of past tense and four types of past tense, and next we will discuss the future tense, four types of future tense. Dear learners, follow the chart carefully and take down, write down the chart and keep practicing at home.
Here we go.
Dear students, in the meantime, we have completed present tense and past tense. Four types of present tense and four types of past tense. Now we will discuss future tense, future indefinite or future simple, future continuous, future perfect, and future perfect continuous. Four types of future tense. And the rule number one, for present indefinite or present simple, follow the rule: subject plus shall or will plus he one means base form of verb, then object plus extension. Subject shall or will, he one, verb one, base form of verb, then object, then extension. Now follow the example. He will catch fish in the river. He will catch fish in the river. Dear learners, here subject is he. He subject, then auxiliary will. Auxiliary will. Naturally, we will use will with all subjects, and sometimes we can use shall with first person I or we. Then verb, base form of verb, he one, verb one, cast, caught. Cast is main form, mul, cast is base form of verb. Then object, fish, an extension in the river. Dear learners, then future continuous tense, rule: subject plus shall be or will be, plus verbing, ing with verb, then object plus extension. Example: we will be learning English, here we subject, then auxiliary will be, then learning, ing with verb, learning, then object, English, and no extension in the sentence. So subject auxiliary will be, then verb with ing, then object, English. Then future perfect tense, subject shall have or will have, then past participle of verb, past participle or v3, verb 3, object plus extension. Example: she will have prepared her lesson. Here subject she subject, then auxiliary will have, helping verb will have, then past participle of verb prepared, have prepared, past participle, then object her lesson. Dear learners, now last tense, tense number 12, future perfect continuous, rule: subject shall have been or will have been, plus verb with ing, or then object, object plus for or since, for or since plus time. Again, subject shall have been or will have been, shall have been or will have been plus verb in, ing with verb, then object plus for or since plus time. And I have told earlier that for is used with indefinite time and since is used for definite time. Example, he will have been learning computer for 3 months. His subject, auxiliary will have been, then learning, have learned, verb learn, and I have added ing with this verb, then learning, object, computer, then for or since plus time, have 3 months, not definite time, indefinite time, and this time can be counted by hours. That's why we have to use for 3 months. Dear learners, this was a today's lecture on tense, the most important topic in case of grammar for the second language learners. Dear learners, I have tried to show you 12 tenses in the chart, and I'm sure you won't face any problem with the chart or with this rule if you try your best at home, if you try frequently at home. Dear learners, and notice, I have given 12 examples, and that's a sequence with the examples, subject, auxiliary, subject, then auxiliary, then verb, then object, and then extension. And if you can understand only one rule, then you will easily understand the other next rules. Dear learners, if you can master this tense or these rules of tenses, then you won't face any problem in other grammatical items. And hope you will practice and improve practicing at home. Dear learners, stay well, be careful. And in the next class, we will discuss another topic. Until then, best of luck. Thank you.